All right, so I just had to restart Firefox here. This is the default server page, the root page for my server. If I were to go to server.pointybracket.net, and I actually get the exact same page. And so what I can do, I believe, is access the routes on the server as normal. And it works. So what we're doing, as you can see, is we're just setting DNS records internally for this machine that it looks at before it goes out to get the correct DNS information. So again, I'm going to go to Network Dash Tools. We're going to try with like let's try and find Joe's Pizza, a website for them. There we go. So let's see if this will work. This is the IP address I'm getting. So I'm going to check if that IP address will route to the website as well. Nope, but it routes to this page. So this is the page we should see after we paste this into our hosts file. So let's go ahead and save. And then let's go to go forward slash. No, let's close this. And there we go. And so you can see how this works is basically it routes to whatever we want to route to. So you could create shortcuts for your favorite websites. With the exception of Google. Google does a lot of internal routing and stuff. And sometimes this will work, sometimes it won't. It all depends on how the web server is set up. Usually, though, I just use the hosts file to set domains to go to my local host, and that's for when I'm developing something that a URL needs to be set with. So if I'm developing a WordPress site on my local machine, and I need to set a URL in the WordPress configuration, I would configure a domain and then point that to my local host. So that is the hosts file. Let's exit out of here. I'll close this. Going to clear that. So now our host name. A host name is basically a name of machine. And in this instance, ours is called Voltron, and we can see that because we've got this right here. So you can use the host name much like the same way you can use custom hosts that you set. So I can just go to Voltron, and it's going to route to my Apache default page. Now you can also update the host name, and we need to do a couple things in order to do that. So first, we're going to run the command sudo hostname ctl set dash hostname, and then whatever host we want to name it to. So Megazord. Now we need to edit the hosts file to update our host name here as well. So we're going to replace Voltron with Megazord. I'm going to save this and close it. And then we're going to run sudo service hostname restart. There. It said it failed to restart the hostname service, but it looks like its working hostname is now set to Megazord. And if I were to close the browser and reopen it, I should be able to go to Megazord forward slash, and it does in fact redirect me to my default Apache 2 page. And so that's what a host name is and how to change it on Ubuntu. You could also change it through the system settings, but we're not going to go through a GUI way to do this right now. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys found this informative. If you have any questions, just leave a comment. Otherwise, I'll see you guys soon.